Hello, Lamb here. Look what I've got. I bought one of those Harley Benton single cut, mustn't say Les Paul, single cut kits. £88, which is pretty unbelievable. What's more unbelievable is I put it as a business expense, so I didn't have to pay the VAT. So about 70 odd quid. I did a time lapse of me putting it together, so I should probably show you that first. Here it is. Right, so here we go with the time lapse. I feel I should be commentating really quickly to keep up with the pace. They should make this an Olympic event, just putting guitars together. So I kind of followed the manual, but didn't. And that caused a couple of fuck-ups. First of all, you'll see the bridge pins are installed. That's a fuck-up because the earth lead isn't in there yet, but I'll fix that later. All the stuff that comes with the kit is pretty good. There's only two types of screw, long ones and small ones. It doesn't tell you what to put where, but it's pretty easy to figure it all out. But the manual is good, so it's an easy kit to put together, really. As long as you follow the manual, you can't really go wrong. So I didn't, so I fucked up. The tuner's installed nicely there. That was easy. Next thing, this little black piece of shit, because the holes weren't in the right place, so it didn't. It was just a swine to get it right, so I gave it the finger there at the end of the. Yep, there you go. That little bastard drove me to drink. There. You have to have booze. It's essential when constructing any guitar, otherwise, it doesn't rock when you're finished. Please drink responsibly. A lot of off-camera faffing again. What was this? Trying to get the jack on. Again, they drilled the hole to the jack plate slightly wonky, so it didn't quite line up, and it was a bit of a bitch. And again, it's another part of the build that just got the finger. Although, to be honest, it was probably my fault more. It was all right in the end. Come on, put the guitar down, you fat twat. Let's see what's going on. This is the point where I realise I fucked up on the bridge post ground connection, so I had to do a quick Google to see how to get that fucker back out of there. But it wasn't too hard. There we go, back in. Job done. I also consulted the manual to see what pickup went where. They were colour-coded white and black. And I had my multimeter, so I thought I'd just measure the resistances there. So the neck one was 7.4K. Bridge one was 13.5, for anyone who's playing along at home. And I gotta say, most of these fittings actually went in really nicely. The pickup rings. I pretty much did the whole build with the one screwdriver. The switch was a pain in the arse, because you just have to keep trying combinations until you find the one that works. But I got there in the end, and that's what matters. Putting the pots in was boring, just the usual thing. I know I should probably use a proper socket there, but I just used the pliers and was careful not to fuck the front of the guitar up. Probably don't advise that. There's the bridge wire, you little shit. Get in there. Plugging it in, tapping around to find out what works and what doesn't work. Oh, this is quite boring to watch, really, isn't it? I thought I was going to be a clever bastard by doing a time lapse. Now I realise it's just. I had a professional commentator do this because I've run out of things to say. And this is far more interesting than any sports that I've ever seen. You'll notice I'm not using the finest tools procured 20 years ago from a bucket in my dad's garage. I was a little bit disappointed with the poker chip, just because the nut kind of goes over the wording, but it's a minor thing. But you can see there's just so many wires, well, the length of wires. I suppose you've got to get them all through the holes and stuff, so they give you plenty of spare wire to make it easy. But if I do this again, I'm going to solder and do everything to the right length just to get rid of the fucking bird's nest that's in the back of there. Here we go, neck going on, get the screws into the right place. The neck went on really easily, which was great. I mean, this is a good kit. So, and that's it. That's the end of the time lapse. So, now some sounds. Here we go. I'll start on, what's this? Rhythm pickup, look. I'm going to keep it clean for a start so you get an idea of the pickups. Mm-hmm. of the things I did was throw away the complete, utter bullshit strings that they send you with the kit. They just look like, I don't know, they'd be ripped off a fence or something. So I bought a... I bought a set of elixirs, especially for it. Close enough, fuck it. Right. Middle position. Treble position, otherwise known as bridge. There you go. And now for my YouTube spectacular, I'm going to do something that's never been attempted before, and that's Comfortably Numb on a Les Paul for star guitar. Whoa. Oh, sorry, I had to stop there. It felt like my shirt was about to become tie-dyed. Anyway, that's it. That's the Harley Benton Les Paul kit. I'm probably going to be doing more with this. Probably going to paint it, some other things. But for 80-odd quid, it was a fun afternoon to put it together. And it's a cracking guitar. It's great. 80 quid, man. I can't believe it. Anyway, there we go. Stay safe. Be healthy. Stay indoors. Don't play Comfortably Numb on a Les Paul. Lamb out.